My name is Zachary Kulke. I am a welder and fabricator. A welder gets to play with fire and electricity a lot. On the most grandiose scale, it's pretty much shooting bottle lightning into a volcano. There are three different forms of welding. You have MIG welding, which is metal inert gas. That's for most production welding. You have what is colloquially known as stick welding, which is shielded metal arc welding, which is the big electrodes for heavy duty welding, buildings, bridges, things like that. And then for the really fine detail work, you'll use TIG welding, which is tungsten inert gas welding. And it leaves a very clean, polished look at the end. And it's such an interesting field that you can get into any aspect of daily life. And you can look at any corner of a room, and there's probably something that was welded. With everything going on as far as energy demands internationally, you know, depending on if pipelines or oil rigs in North South Dakota need to be fabricated, you have plenty of jobs there that are going to be up and coming. High rises in New York City or LA, even around the world, there are places that, you know, high rises are always going up. I think a lot of it is the fact that the skill was so diminished, I would say, over the course of the past couple of decades. You have the baby boomers who learned it either right after World War II and have been in the trade skills for the past 40 or 50 years who are now trying to retire and get out of it. So there is a huge gap of information and skill that needs to be filled. There are a set of codes and standards which almost all places will follow, and that's set by the American Welding Society. If you go through a certain course, you can become a certified welding inspector to make sure that all of those guidelines are met with every weld on a job. More often than not, those certifications are for areas such as pipe welding, boiler makers, iron workers, etc., etc. As far as high school students go, you're going to need to know, or at least can tolerate, most maths. If you want to work for a metallurgical company to, you know, like R&D department sort of things, creating new filler material, et cetera, et cetera, you need a lot more chemistry to know that. You will need to know some types of physics for the jobs you're working with, especially if you're a fabricator along with just doing welding. More often than not, the two kind of go hand in hand. My parents went to college. They want all the best for us, and I think that's what parents want, nothing but the best for their kids. And I think a lot of times the only avenue that people see is the four-year university, graduating with a bachelor's, then going and getting a master's and possibly a doctorate, et cetera, et cetera. But I find that a lot of people with skilled trades have a more rewarding life